Good Sunday morning, everybody, from Crossroads Chapel. It is Brother Bucky, and I'm going to do something a little different here. My good friend Robert, who runs our website, morning, Evan.
Morning.
He has kind of dubbed these Bucky's Corner, and so normally I give you an inspirational, you know, scripture or something that's on my mind, but I wanted to share this today. A story of overcoming and redemption. I have two dear friends that are going through a difficult battle right now. My buddy's wife has been in the hospital for today, or tomorrow will mark 3 weeks. And their story is one that's been shared here before. You can see his testimony in some of the previous messages that we've done. It was, I think, a couple of years ago now, but how both of them had been incarcerated, and they wanted a life change when they got out of prison. Some from our motorcycle ministry with this gentleman, you know, wrote letters and just encouraged him. And when they got out of jail, they met on a bus, and it's a true love story. There's just no question about that. And the ups and the downs that God allows us to go through, because it points to the faith necessary to get through these things and better on the other side, is really what's at the heart of their relationship. Their relationship with Jesus Christ, and the understanding that no matter what, God is going to get them through the circumstances they find themselves in. And the Bible tells us that we're made overcomers by the blood of the Lamb. And I know that sometimes the things that I talk about are just, for me now, they're natural. But for a lot of people, they don't understand that. I just want you to know, no matter where you're hearing this, whether you are in jail or, you know, a lot of times we look at jail like the four walls and the razor wire. That's not what keeps us in jail. That's not what keeps us in bondage. What it is a life of sin. And when I say that, I don't mean like you're out doing debauchery and killing people and stealing. There is a void that is missing. If there is a void missing in your life, that void is Jesus Christ, and he's the only thing that can fill that void. And for these two, they are the perfect example. And they're not perfect people, but they're striving toward and pressing toward that mark that is a high calling. That's what they have decided to focus on. It's their faith, their relationship in Jesus Christ. So I just want to put a shout out to my friends Fred and Cheryl, because we love you. You are part of this family. And may God bless you in this journey as we stand with you. And I hope you all take some encouragement from this today. God bless you and have a great day.